I want to read one verse from 2 Timothy chapter 2. I will read verse 8. And here it says, Paul says here, remember Jesus Christ. Remember Jesus Christ, risen from the dead, descendant of David, according to my gospel. You may be seated. Apostle Paul, who writes in several letters about the sufferings, about the death of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, about the Lord's Supper, about the Lord's table. Here in this verse, he launches these words as a challenge to Timothy. And this morning, he launches these words as a challenge to all of us. And I want to reread this verse, only the first three words. He says here, remember Jesus Christ. And this is also the title of my message this morning. Remember Jesus Christ. Like I already mentioned, the Lord's Supper, it's a very special moment for the church. It's a time of remembrance. It's a time where we think and remember about Jesus Christ, about his sufferings, about his death, about what he has done for us. But not only that, every time we have communion, we also send out a message. Because also Paul says in 1 Corinthians 11:26, for as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And in order for us to be able to proclaim this message of his death, well, in order for us, first of all, we have to do something. We must remember him. We must remember what he has done for us, and we always have to remember what price he paid for us. However, this morning, I would like not only to remember him, but let's also remember about ourselves, where he took us out from. Let's remember what he saved us from. Because brothers and sisters, when we look back on our past, I'm 100% sure that all of us, we will remember with pleasure certain moments, certain times of our life, right? But it's equally certain that when we look back on our past, that we will find some situation, some times that we are not very proud of, right? But in order to be able to rejoice this morning at the Lord's table, to be able to understand it better, this special moment, before that, we have to do something, and we have to remember. And the first thing that I want all of us to remember this morning is that we were born in sin. Psalm 51, verse 5, David says here, behold, I was brought forth in guilt, and in sin my mother conceived me. And this is a fact that we should never forget, brothers and sisters, especially not on a communion Sunday. We have to remember where we are coming from, and we have to remember what Jesus saved us from. Also, David says in Psalm 40, verse 2, he brought me up of the pit of destruction, out of the mud, and he set my feet on a rock, making my footsteps firm. And in prophet Isaiah, he urges us in chapter 51, verse 1, look to the rock from which you were cut, and to the quarry from which you were dug. And that's what we have to do, brothers and sisters. We have to look to the rock from which we were cut. And who is our rock? It's Jesus Christ. But you know what? We also have to look to the pit, or we also have to remember the pit where he took us out from. Because who else would be able to take us out from this pit? Who else would be able to take us out from the mud that we were sinking in deeper and deeper? No one, only him, only Jesus, like we sang before. He was the only one who was ready to come and to save us from the sad situation that we were in. Listen to what Titus says in 3 verse 3. For we too were once foolish, disobedient, deceived, enslaved to various lusts and pleasures, spending our life in malice and envy, hateful, hating one another. Ephesians 2:1, and you were dead in your offenses and sins. And this is something that we have to remember when we approach the Lord's table. And let's never forget what Jesus saved us from, because if we do that, we will understand it much more when we're standing at the Lord's table, and we will cherish moments like this. Amen? So we will never forget, but we will always remember that we were born in sin, that we were foolish, disobedient, deceived, like we read. We were in the mud. That's what we have to remember this morning. But not only that, we also have to remember this morning the big price that was paid for you and me. And that's the second point I want to talk about this morning. Let's remember the price that was paid for us and for our salvation. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 6:20, for you have been bought for a price. And what I want to tell you here is that the price always determines the value of an object, right? For example, you can buy a car for $5,000 and you can buy a car for a couple hundred thousand dollars. You can buy a house for $400,000, not here in California, but you can somewhere for sure. And you can buy a house for a couple million dollars, right? So the more value there is on an object, the higher the price, right? And Apostle Peter says in 1 Peter chapter 1:18 and 19, knowing that you are not redeemed with perishable things like silver or gold from your futile way of life inherited from your forefathers, but with precious blood, as of a lamb unblemished and spotless, the blood of Christ. Brothers and sisters, this is the price that was paid for us. This is the value that we have in God's eyes. This is the value that we have in God's heart. Blessed be our Lord. Amen? Amen. And then in 1 Timothy 2, 5 and 6, it says, for there is one God and one mediator also between God and mankind, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all, the testimony given at the proper time. So here is what we need to remember when we have communion. First of all, we have to remember that we were born in sin. We have to remember that we were dead in sin. And secondly, we have to remember the price, the unspeakable high price that was paid for our salvation. And what I want to tell you here is, he gave us a great value. He values us a lot, enormously. You know why? Because the price that was paid for us was enormously. His only Son, the Lamb of God, his precious and holy blood. This was the price that was paid for you and me, and we reconciled with God. And this morning, I want to ask all of you, when we will approach the Lord's table, when we will be holding the bread and the cup, let's remember this. Let's remember the price that was paid for our salvation. Because all gold and all silver that exists on this planet Earth would not have been able to pay for our guilt. Only the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was able to wash away our sins. He saved us by his blood, and not only that, he also gave us the pledge, which is the Holy Spirit, and he also made us heirs with him together. Blessed be his name. Thirdly, my third point that I want us to remember, it's from our main text, the first three words. Let's remember Jesus Christ. After we remembered ourselves, our past, the price that was paid for our salvation, let's now remember him. Let's remember Jesus Christ. And like David says in Psalm 34, verse 5, they looked to him and were radiant. And may the Holy Spirit enlighten us this morning. May the Holy Spirit fill us with joy, with the joy of salvation. Amen. Brothers and sisters, when we are at such a special moment like the Lord's Supper, we always have to remember Jesus Christ. And when we remember Jesus Christ, we have to ask ourselves, do I know Jesus Christ? I mean, do I know him personally? Or do I know about him? Because you know what? Listen to that. Matthew 21:10. When he had entered Jerusalem, all the city was stirred, saying, who is this? Mark 4:41, the disciples. They became very much afraid and said to one another, who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him? Acts 9, verse 5. Saul from Tarsus says here, who are you, Lord? So I read you all these verses because I wanted to show you that it can be possible that you know a lot about Jesus Christ, but you do not know him at all. And he is very interested that we know him personally. Even he himself, he asks the question in Matthew 16:13, who do people say that the Son of Man is? And then Peter, he speaks up and he answers in verse 16, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And you know what? I want to admit the same thing today. When I will be standing at the Lord's table, I want to say the same thing. You are the Christ, the Lord, the Son of the living God. Amen? And Paul says also that he is the gift from God. He is the gift that God gave us. 2 Corinthians 9:15. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. And Apostle James says in James 1:17, every good thing given and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights. And Jesus Christ, he is the perfect gift from God for us people, right? He's the Son of God. He's our Savior. He's the Lion of Judah. He's the Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end. And on this Communion Sunday, brothers and sisters, we have the grace, we have the honor to stand before him and to give him all the glory, all thanks. Amen. On the eighth day after his resurrection, when Apostle Thomas saw him, what did he say? My Lord and my God. And brothers and sisters, today it's our turn to say that. To all of us, we have to say, my Lord and my God. We must remember, especially on a day like this, but always, every day, we must remember that Jesus Christ, his sufferings, his death, his resurrection are the essence or the kernel of the Christian faith. He is the foundation of the entire gospel. And in our verse that we read at the beginning, Paul insists not only to remember him, not only to remember Jesus Christ, but he insists also to remember his resurrection. And you know why? Because his resurrection is the guarantee over our sins. His resurrection is the guarantee over our death. I read from 1 John 2, 1 and 2. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. And if anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus the righteous. And he himself is the propitiation for our sins, and not only for ours only, but also for the sins of the world. and relate it to this verse because it fits very good. It's Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced for our offenses. He was crushed for our wrongdoings. The punishment for our well-being was laid upon him, and by his wound we are healed. And this morning, brothers and sisters, we have to remember him. We have to remember what he has done for us. We have to remember who he truly is and what he means for us. And then my last point is the fourth thing that we have to remember on this special Sunday, on this Communion Sunday, is let's remember who we are now in Christ. This morning we remembered about our past, who we were without Christ. We remembered the unspeakable high price that was paid for our salvation. We remembered Jesus Christ, who he is, how he is, and now let's remember who we are in Christ Jesus. John 1 verse 12 says, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name. 1 John 3, 1 and 2 continues, and he says here, see how great a love the Father has given us, that we would be called children of God. And in fact, we are. For this reason, the world does not know us because it did not know him. Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not appeared as yet what we will be. We know what when he appears. We will be like him because we will see him just as he is. So who are we now, brothers and sisters? Now, you read it, not tomorrow, not sometimes in the future. Now and today, we are children of God. And Paul says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, this person is what? Is a new creation. The old things passed away, behold, new things have come. So not only that we are children of God, we are also a new creation. Amen? And I'll end my message here this morning. I'll invite the worship team to come up to worship the Lord with one more song. And before I end my message, I want to read one more verse, 1 Peter 2 verse 9, because in this verse, Peter points out a few more things that we are in Christ Jesus. And he says here, but you are not like that, for you are chosen people. You are royal priests, a holy nation, God's very own possession. As a result, you can show others the goodness of God, for he called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. Glory to God. So on this morning of Communion Sunday, let's remember Jesus Christ, but also let's remember who we are now and today in Christ Jesus. And like that, we will understand it much more deeply, what it means to approach the Lord's table. May God bless you all. Amen.